This program is rated 13, recommended for family viewing.
The 11th of December 2019, another beautiful morning down here in Kampala, the land of Haswan, where you can get your dreams come true. And of course, another beautiful morning to everyone that is watching us from every part, every corner of the country. My name is Derek Ainedash, and it's time for Urban Today, 2 hours of nothing but infotainment. And remember that the moment the show starts, we are live on Facebook as well as Twitter. All you need to do is log on to our websites or different social media pages for Urban Television, that is Facebook, and at Urban TV Uganda, that is Twitter. Today on the show, we'll be getting into some news coming in as far as Uganda gets ready to hosting, that is the Africa AIDS Conference, one of the biggest conferences that usually happens globally. Now, this year, it's going to be happening down in Rwanda, but come 2021, it's going to be happening down here in Uganda. We have been competing with Kenya to make sure we find out who does get to host this particular conference. Now, in 2021, it happens to be Uganda. I'll be getting you into some news regarding that particular one. And away from that also, I'll be letting you know on the news from Electoral Commission, as far as you know, updating its register is concerned. Apparently, there could be more 5 days for you to actually go and get yourself registered as far as the 2021 general election is concerned. And later on, away from that, we'll be getting into some kachai interesting bit of the show, whereby we'll be having our 10 lucky winners selected today, live on Urban Today, as far as them getting makeup tutorials at Seren Beauty is concerned. Courtesy of the Flyer magazine. Remember, down at New Vision, every magazine comes with something special for you who is actually buying it and filling in the raffle tickets. Now, today on the show, we will be selecting 10 lucky winners that could be enjoying this beautiful tutorials at Seren Beauties as far as makeup is concerned. And also, away from that, we'll be getting into more interviews lined up, and not forgetting Kachai, which will be coming in, as well as the love letter and sports this morning. All that right here for the next 2 hours. For now, Nicholas and Imi are joining me, and definitely, unfortunately, Tina couldn't make it. But yeah, we have Nicholas sitting in for Tina. Good morning, Junik.
I'll keep my line. Let me spare my life for sport this morning. Days of Our Lives. That's, of course, my 11th deck, a few days to Christmas. The name is Zozibini. That is Tunzi. Yes, she's the most beautiful lady in the world.
No, you didn't say that.
Yes. And me?
Well, according to Miss Universe.
No, she's just Miss Universe.
Yes.
Not the most beautiful lady. We are very many beautiful ladies.
Amy, let's be realistic. There's what they call reality check and dream check. I don't know about you, but I do know you're beautiful from the inside.
No, you didn't.
I'm just saying, Miss Amy.
You're feeding me that thing
I'm
of beautiful
representing the
inside.
Loudy, mouthy woman. That's Tina Fierce, baby. And I would like to make this very, very, you know, precise that even as we celebrate Christmas, we've got to appreciate each day that comes. And you, Miss Amy, might appreciate your looks. In your language, I don't know how they say it, but my language, Nozo Kakurung, in Spanish, La Belle.
In French?
French, I have no idea.
Bonjour.
No, that's greeting. But but honestly speaking,
I think
as we embrace our Africanness, we also need to embrace the fact that with or without the cuteness on the outside, the inside also matters. So again, Zozibini.
Zozibini.
So you feel Zozibini is the most beautiful person?
Well, South Africans don't love hair, so I don't know how they had to come down to that, but well.
Can you believe this guy came and stole the paper on set? Like, yeah. He just wanted to grab the paper.
I don't know what's wrong with our brothers.
You see, this is the thing.
What's happening?
For the first time, I wanted to do the Rupine paper. I asked for Rupine. Now the guy says, no, Rupine is only mine. You cannot read it. What do you do with that kind of a person?
She spent about 5 minutes trying to get the price in their language.
I know.
That is airtime going.
No, you know, Chengadek means Wednesday. Oh. Mm-hmm. So I kept thinking Chengadek is actually money. But anyway, going back to beauty. Mm. Banafe, I am still saying Africa. Mm-hmm. Nobody defines you by your brownness or light skinness. Mm-hmm. Stop expecting beauty to be light skin. Beauty is black. Beauty is African. If you were born light, it is okay.
I think that is wrong for us to say beauty is black.
No.
Beauty is
African. Okay. Okay. I am buying that. Mm-hmm. But we have an onset of guys. Actually, ne wa fabe nguru abasinga. We were at a party for our lose. Nenda banga abasinga ngalo zawe za chara kala.
Oh, wangi wali wone za ngone. Twampame na makede.
Adeko sina na kutuka. Na ya Derek. But then Jagara, I first send my legal shout out to Bana Bantu Bengudo. Yunra, Seta opposite Seta High School. Mm-hmm. Bako lokoto rugudo nga batereza pipes. Nae ne walioka baleka nga akaguru mukema nga kari sharp nyo emoto kazi siva zigwa. A friend of mine has sent me that is he stays on the same route. Mm. But he has met that is like the 8th trailer.
Good day yo.
Chokate bagala tereza rugudo. Bambi mtereza rugudo. Nabarada. Wano wansi wanko koro rugudo utwala abantu ebugolobi. That road is a death trap. Banange.
Rungo suse kugali yomuka kurugudo yomuka.
Ya. Haa. Ngogenda.
Ururua food day.
Banange potholes ziliyoko. People are dodging. Wadu wakana kebato mede doko. Like it's just like as if we're waiting for people to die. Then wadu wo mamerito hotel. Kumbia wo. Pothole, but I'm calling you.
What's the tuba tweeting? Galilo, but I'm calling you active.
Mani be kubanye
ngolo. Bani ngolo wa ume masaza wa kujaka masanyala. Zamantu wani mkulaja.
Be kubanye ngwala. Walwa ake chalwa jala wanga wakasengo serengeta quality. Mm. It is so narrow in that wawoli kuboda. Mani waboda baganyo fukina kuraisi.
Mbambi ya.
Mani wawoli kuboda manyati. Averi wagula. Gena kubivivi. Wagena kubombiri kuna. But in other words, our roads are so narrow and in bad state. Naka wanu.
Mga gende wongi. Wali wo pothole insaja jetu wakubye. Toka daba. Ukakubuka tu usi.
Soko inako.
Anti waliwe nsajia ni nkazi.
Waliwe kapotola kalala petualtro za baka gwonze zao tisota road yao. Kupawa house yao. Baka jaone baka feelinga mwao. Waje no kuita weeks. Bidi.
Mbane mtuwa lo kutakabona.
Kutakabona na.
Hawa yae.
Yunrabana ye mutukole ko fix the roads.
Ate bali kumpi genda mu Christmas.
We are going for Christmas.
You know how public workers.
It is bad enough that we are being slaughtered by panga wielding guys. It's bad enough that.
Mungo gina kumbere ya Yunrabana. Temaina chami sana chami sana chiba binza what?
Genda, baadhi kwa
engineer, kwa kuba engineer, ba na baabu dijoma na abad sime nguuda
wengine.
Temaina mazee mwajaka la da
mumbani mizasa. No, wadiwo kaina kadia sentenza. When these things are budgeted, magamba. Guy wadu gudo bagena muwe mitwali etano lunaku. Oshegera. Oye mitwali. Ne wali waka ina kajia kwa gusuru. Ne kajia waka kagamba. Oyo ngena muwa gumuchitu.
Eze mukole rechi.
Ne kanzenzi bike. Kati wajio kusaininga. Amgamba. Sainiinga wanu. Just sainiinga. Kati ena gaya najuza.
Gobera yo.
Mimani.
Gobera yo ina evidence. Ewe kwa kumisemi time wazembamu lila. Moving away from that, of course, we want to get into some shout-outs coming in right about now. But before the shout-outs, let's take a quick look at some starting news coming in. Now, apparently, Uganda is to host Africa AIDS Conference. Now, Uganda has won the bid to host the International Conference on AIDS and Sexually Transmitted Infection in Africa, that is ACASA, in December 2021. According to the acting existing director of the Uganda Media Center, Dennis Katunji, the ICASA will take place from the December 6th 2021. Uganda competed with Kenya for the bid to host the event, which is the biggest on the continent. The conference brings together leaders, experts, academicians, and civil society activists from Africa and other continents to discuss how the world can use science to combat HIV scourge in Africa. Now, the 20th ICASA conference will be held this year in Kigali, Rwanda, under the theme AIDS-Free Africa, Innovative Community and Political Leadership. The target of ICASA is to achieve an AIDS-free Africa. And according to the World Health Organization in Uganda, the prevalence of HIV among adults that is 15 to 64 years of age is 6.2, which is equivalent to 1.2 million people of the same age bracket that are living with HIV in the country.
In the long run, I think we shall soon have an HIV-free Uganda, not just Uganda, but also cutting across the continent, because I think now there is so much awareness, so much sensitization, and even then when we try to picture the scenario of one dying of HIV every day, you also have to think of the part of we the people trying to fight it, and even then those that have it are trying to, you know, aware the rest and not stigmatize, not part of, there's
the
other worry.
Stigma isn't as bad as it was then.
There's other worry of, you know, curbing it and trying to spread it. I think that as well should be looked into as far as the law gets to go, because that for me is like direct murder. I mean, in Kaina,
or like when you know you have it and then you get, but I think it's a mental state also.
Let's move away from that and of course take a quick look at some shout outs coming in. My shout out is going into the Electoral Commission. Now, the Electoral Commission is undertaking the update of National Voters Register for the purposes of the 2020-2021 general elections. Now, the general update exercise commenced on Thursday, 21st November 2019, and was scheduled to close tomorrow, Wednesday, 11th December 2019. However, due to high demand and numbers of applicants at the update centers since the beginning of this week and requests from stakeholders in the electoral process, the Electoral Commission has found it necessary to take decision to extend the update period, which was scheduled to close on Wednesday, 11th December, for five more days, starting from Thursday, 12th, and ending Monday, 16th December 2019, after which there will be no further extension. The exercise will continue to be conducted at updated stations in each parish throughout Uganda, starting from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. throughout the extended period, included weekends. Now, please note that the purpose of this extension is to provide an opportunity for eligible persons who have not yet registered to do so. The general public is therefore reminded to clearly observe the following part. One, that is, this is not a fresh registration of voters, but an exercise to enable Ugandan citizens who have attained the age of 18 years and above and who have not yet registered to register as voters in order to participate in elections. A registered voter who wishes to transfer to the new voting location shall be able to do so during this period. Please note that such a voter who wishes to transfer to a new voting location must present confirmation that he or she originates from is at the time of application for transfer a resident of the parish of that new voting location. Such applicants should ensure they have details of their previous voting locations. The Electoral Commission has availed the National Voters Register for each polling station at the update center in each parish so that existing voters check and confirm their registration status. That is, whether their particulars are well captured. Emerging issues from the update exercise, the Electoral Commission has noted that with concern, reports of alleged extortion of money by some local leaders and update officials from applicants in order to sign on the applications before processing the applications. This is illegal and the Commission strongly commends it. The Commission has provided all necessary forms free of charge. The Commission also calls on the officials involved in the update exercise to desist from any acts that may frustrate eligible applicants from exercising their constitutional rights to apply for registration as voters. The Electoral Commission urges all eligible persons who are not yet registered as voters and those who wish to apply for the transfer of voting locations to use this opportunity and do so in order to participate in the general elections. The commission also appeals to eligible public servants and other eligible persons in formal employment to take advantage of this extension, particularly this weekend. For God and my country, Justice Byamukama Mujeni Simon, Chairperson, Electoral Commission.
I think in a way, EC have got to be very cautious this time around, because marches, we all have frustration. Frustration, I mean, you know, you did register yourself in a certain area, you get there, you don't find your name there, you're told to go to another zone or another, you know, place, and it gets really bad because then marches are trying to, you know, have your leader elected. There's also that system, and we as the voters, we as the public, we as the local citizens also need to, you know, have the discipline, because if you know this is where you registered, and if you know these are the rightful names you use, because sometimes, again, the names can beat you up, they can tank your chances of actually, you know, casting your vote. If you're once a mister and then you get married and then now you're a miss, rather a miss, and now you're a missus, that again also, you know, false. But EC has also got to, you know, put that into consideration, but sometimes the people tend to shift from place A to place B, and the names as well change. But that being said, Mandima Nyendaga Mount is enough for you, you know, to go and cast your vote.
No, Fred Muwaya, electoral commission.
And I'm sorry, I'm going to say I told you so. Era Tina Jordi, swallow my words this time.
It's a humble party.
We were on this same set, and I say these guys are going to find a way of extorting money from people. I know Chidabia Wano. Alleged extortion of money by some local leaders. Guys, when you go to get your stuff updated, if you're going to check if you're eligible to vote and your name is there, do not pay anybody any money and stand up and say, don't be polite and say, Bambi Nyamba. No! Tarimu Kuyamba, it is your right and you deserve it. You do not pay anything for it. When you get there, tell the guy, I am here for this. There's a line, make it up. When you get there, and that's a person, you're fighting for other people. We are done with
But that being said, I want to believe that over the years, there's been so much negativity from the side of EC, whether there is actually any truthfulness in what they deliver. And they've lost faith. Rather, people have lost faith in them.
Trust.
I want to believe that this time around, 2021, they've come out, you know, to sensitize people. And that being said, protect your vote going into 2021, whether you choose to, you know, to vote, that will be entirely up to you. But most importantly, let there be peace and harmony. I would love to have that, at least for just the one time, because the last elections,
Actual. Let's go to your area of the crowned Zozibini Tuzi, who was crowned Miss Universe on Sunday night after excelling through rounds of swimsuit and evening gown struts. Questions on social issues and one final chance to explain why she was the right choice. She says, I grew up in a world where a woman who looks like me, with my kind of skin and my kind of hair, was never considered to be beautiful. That's what she said. And she also said, I think it is time that this stops today. I want children to look at me and see my face, and I want them to see their faces reflected in mine. Being on the Miss Universe stage is not just a dream. I believe that I found my mission. It's a representation of dedication, resilience, and perseverance. I do believe my mission is to show the world that magic happens when we refuse to give up, because the universe always listens to a stubborn heart. And if you're wondering, yes, there was another mix-up and Steve Harvey was involved in it. But it was nothing like the 2015 disaster when he called out the wrong winner.
I know, with the moustache and all that. But she didn't bleach the skin, but she bleached the teeth quite very white.
You have it, of course, for the shout-outs coming in right about now. What we're going to do at this point, we're going for a very small breather. When we do get back, we want to take a quick look at what is making headlines in our Press Digest. Looking at the new vision this particular morning, still going for only 2,000 Ugandan shillings, 11th of December, and just a reminder, 13 days to hit Christmas. Yes, that means that the days are just around the corner. Family of 10 killed in floods. Seven speaks out on fatal floods, And of course, I'm still bringing you more details, talking about 1,000 people living in camps. Details on page 3, 15, 16, and 17. And also another interesting headline on page 4, cryptocurrency scam. Hundreds of victims storm CID. Now you can grab yourself some details right there in today's copy of the New Vision. 7 routes for resettlement fund. This is coming in on page 3, and we have a president's statement right there regarding this particular one, so you can grab yourself a copy of the New Vision, get to see what the president has to say regarding the people that were affected by the floods. 2 years of primary education at West. This is a report that is coming in right here as far as our different teaching methods are concerned. So you can grab yourself a copy and get to catch up with more of those details right there. EC extends voter registration for 5 days, and this is costing 6 billion Ugandan shillings. Interesting news coming in. A suspected robbers shot dead in Mutundwe. This is, of course, another one coming in on page 9 of the New Vision. They say that 4 suspected robbers have been shot dead after a shootout with security personnel in Mutundwe, a city suburb. The incident took place yesterday, and we have reports coming in from the police spokesperson, Fred Enanga, only in today's copy of the New Vision. The Mwalimu pullout is also out. Remember, it comes out every Wednesday to keep you updated with what is happening within the education sector. Toto magazine is also out for the kids out there in the holiday season. And flipping to the backside, we have some sports news coming in both on the international and local scenes at only 2,000 Ugandan shillings.
Well, the Daily Monitor on this fine day, Wednesday, Dec 11, 2019, their headline is Bank of Uganda explains Uganda's drop in Uganda's economy. They also have furthermore of that story on page number 4, something on His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni ordering landslide victims to relocate. Security officers kill 4 suspected armed thugs. As for Uganda as a country, they got to win the global award for climate change. And furthermore, the BOU came coming out to explain the drop in economy, in Uganda's economy. That is, of course, something that was explained by the deputy governor of Bank of Uganda, Mr. Louis Kasekende. And that is 2%, according to this report. Something more coming through right there on page 6. Quite an interesting story, because then a former Sheraton Hotel employee coming out to seek shillings 120 in compensation. Why? Because he believes he did contract Parkinson disease while working at Sheraton Hotel. And more details on that story on page 10. Something on the landslide. 16 bodies being recovered. Very, very sad report coming through from the Elgon landslides. That's on page 13. And also 260 still further on the landslides. 260 landslide victims stuck with no food. Very, very, very sad right there. And sports, last push for the Cranes in Hong Kong finale. That's as far as the ICC Cricket League World Cup League 2 gets to go. Further more on that story on Game 1 later on this afternoon.
All right, let's move on. What's happening?
Lero nine mpapura bidi. Nino re wafe orwa rupinyi. Nina norwa bukede. Kakati bukede. Ensonga nya okuguru papura rwa bukede. Soka. Papura rwa siri njisiru kumiru mbwerut. Tenga muna ye. Osopro duso manabe nganda. Nabe chikaneye bambi. Ngalere rwa bukede. Etanjise nantisa. Bagambia batia. Ababi katikubata ani achogede owa UPDF lwachi ensongeri mbukede wegulio papuloro. Banki enkuru erabudde ku sente ze bawandiseko. Mbwaba bagenda beunza bewandisa kusente z'abantu. Funa bukede manche bagendo bakolira. Freeman naye ali wana ali mawulira agamba ki gulabukede. Abatta abantu e Masaka gubasinze kye bagenda bakola ki. Chidi mbukede, of course, mbukwa singide kwa kutaba, ya ibadi mkutaba, nduwa chita nate babata. Okwe waandisa mubyo kuronda, bakuongeza yo, echo chikuru, erabambi mugende, mwekebele, nti muyo legit voters. Bambi, nechino chanaku, erachantisa, erachitaro nyo, omwano muyizi kathi na kambugu, miaka 14 bamuse, neba muocha, wa, eraluachi, bukede. Era mbukede, era bya sekukuru, bakuwabula, engeri gy'ogenda kozesa sente, ani gogendo ziwako, Kenza ali muno, Kampala ne Bobby ali muno, bakola ki bifananyi ki, wetanire bukede. Ebya sports rubya nabikola. ensonga emu yokka lwaki ogenda kwevunira olupapula lwa rupinyi ebusooka ogenda yiga nti kyeŋade kitegeeza olunaku olwokusatu olwa wiiki that is Wednesday eyokubiri olupapula lwa siringi siringi 11 bweruti bambi guys buy yourselves a copy of Rupee. It's only 1,000 shillings. I am also trying my level best to learn.
Tetukiriza.
We are fighting corruption. This is corruption. Tuanza kwaje mkwazi.
Sibo wakati.
Kigambo chimu.
No
chiga.
No, I am looking
for the headline.
Headline. La rongom.
Chitegeza.
Chitegeza.
Bala msomesa bana mnimize wamwe.
Tume wano.
Let's go in for a very short break, but of course when we do get back, we'll be selecting 10 lucky winners to win a makeup tutorial done at Serenity, courtesy of the Flair Magazine.